Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to the first game of the 2019 season. Tonight, we've got a great match coming at you. Arrowhead Warhawks against the Waukesha South Blackshirts. And here come your Warhawks, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight's game is the first game of the Classic 8 season for your Arrowhead Warhawks. As you know, your Warhawks are led by Coach Fritz Rauch, and the Waukesha South Blackshirts are coached by A.J. Rabel. Now we have for you here the Marching Warhawks.
Join the band in honoring our great recognized for the playing of the national anthem. Everybody who is able, please rise. Gentlemen, remove your hats. As the marching Warhawks, under the direction of Sarah Dunmeyer and Jacob Poyanich, perform the national anthem. There is a 50-50 raffle. You can support your Arrowhead cheer team by participating in the 50-50 raffle. Tickets are 2 for $5, 5 for $10, or 15 tickets for $20. You have a chance to get 50% of the profit. The other half will go towards the cheerleaders' uniform fund. The ticket table is located at the north entrance of the stadium. The winner will be announced at the beginning of the fourth quarter, and you must be present to win. Blackshirts to start the game.
And just like that, folks, the football season is underway. This should be a good game, folks. I hope you're really excited. It's time to brush off those backpacks, get those calculators ready to roll, because school is about to begin. I know that because here I am at the first Arrowhead football game of the year.
Now's pass attempt is incomplete. Back on the coverage for the Warhawks, number 14, Tanner Shutt. Pass was intended for number 26, Ezekiel Diaz, second down and 10.
Second down and 10. Nice stop there by the Warhawks. Third down coming up.
Fair catch is taken by number 11, Brady Russ. Warhawks will have a first and 10 at their own 49-yard line.
What a great start for the Arrowhead defense. Now it's the offense's turn to see what they can do. First down and 10 to go from the 49-yard line. What a great run by Josh Nielsen. Let's see what that penalty is, folks. Oh, it looks like it's coming back. Catch there by Robbie Simden. Robbie's a senior and he's looking forward to trying to play football at the next level. Now let's see what Arrowhead can do with this first down.
Second down and 9. down the arrows. Pass attempt is complete to number two, Luke Peterson. Gain is to the 31-yard line. Third down and eight. Brings up second down and 10. Broken up by number 12, Eli Hoyt. For the Blackshirts. Crosses back to the 28-yard line. Third down and 19.
All right, guys, it's fourth down, and it looks like we're going for a field goal attempt here. This would be Ty Bittman attempting the kick. Ty is a junior. There is 6 minutes and 54 seconds left in the first quarter, and the kick is up. And no good, missed it left. Blackshirts ball coming up.
Zero and the Warhawks zero. Back to number 47, Joseph Kulap. Brought down on the play by number 5, Dalton Elrod. No gain on the play, second down and 10. Jordan McNello on the scramble. Pass is incomplete. Brings up third down and 10. Pressure on the play by number 3, Will Bond.
Third and 10 for the Blackshirts, 5 minutes and 53 seconds to go in the first quarter. And we are on the 20-yard line. Oh, there's a flag. False start on the Blackshirts. Now we have third down and 15 from the 15-yard line.
Attempt is incomplete. Back on the coverage for the Warhawks, number 27, 0-8. Touchdown by number 10 for the Blackshirts, Sebastian Jefferson. Warhawks will have a first and 10 at the Blackshirts 36-yard line. Number 29, Josh Nielsen. He gets it down to the 25-yard line. First and 10 for the Warhawks.
Touchdown, Warhawks! Luke Peterson, the senior, with the touchdown to give the Arrowhead Warhawks the lead at 6-0. And here's the extra point attempt. Ty Bittman out. It's up. And it's good. It's good, and that's got to feel good for the Warhawks after missing that field goal earlier this quarter. I got to tell you, these Warhawk fans are hungry for a win tonight. It's Hawaiian night for the students, and they are ready to have a luau in the stands. It is currently 7-0, Arrowhead winning. 4 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the first quarter, and Arrowhead is about to kick off. And the kick is up. It's going right down the middle, and the Blackshirts field it. They're running up right down the middle, and he's brought down at around the 24-yard line.
Brought down the play by number 52 for the Warhawks, Luke Grunzel. Returned by number 12 for the Blackshirts, Eli Hoyt. First and 10 for the Blackshirts at their own 23.
Third and five Blackshirts on the 28-yard line. 3:32 to go in the first quarter. Oh, big play there for the defense. Big play. First down on the 21-yard line, Arrowhead ball coming up. Tommy Darrow, nice job on the QB sneak. Well, not really sneak, more of just a run. It wasn't that sneaky. Great job, though. It is now 13-0, and Arrowhead coming on to kick the extra point. 3 minutes and 4 seconds left in the first quarter. Point after attempt is good. 14-0 Arrowhead.
Just picked up by number four, Tyler Vinton, goes into the end zone. Blackshirts will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Attempt is complete on the play. Brought down by number 14, Tanner Shutt. There is a penalty flag down on the play. False start on the black shirts. 5-yard penalty. Take it back to the 15. First down and 15.
First and 15, 2 minutes, 39 seconds to go in the first quarter. Incomplete pass. Second down.
26, Ezekiel Diaz is incomplete. Out of the coverage for the Warhawks, number 15, Will Lutterbach. Second down and 15.
Third and 13 coming up here, 1 minute and 51 seconds and counting in the first quarter. Blackshirts have the ball at the 17-yard line. And their current score is 14-0 Arrowhead over the Waukesha South Blackshirts. And there you have a turnover, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, what a play. That was Tanner Shutt, number 14, with the interception. Great job, Tanner. So we're gonna have first down and 10 on the 17-yard line. Arrowhead's got the ball with a minute and 34 left in this quarter.
Tommy Darrow's passing attempt is complete to number two, Luke Peterson.
Second and 7 on the 14, a minute and 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Time is counting down. Current score is 14-0, Arrowhead. This will be an exciting year in the Classic 8 Conference. As you may or may not know, we had two state champions come out of the conference last year as Luke Peterson makes the catch. That was good for a first down. Nice job, boys. Here we go with first and goal from the 6. 55 seconds left in the first quarter. Oh, number 13 with the run, and he is in! Touchdown, Warhawks! Can anyone stop this kid? I don't know, but we hopefully won't find out anytime soon. The score is 20-0, Arrowhead. Here comes the extra point unit. Nothing now. Arrowhead, great job. Let's take a quick peek over there at our cheerleaders, our band, and ooh, they just didn't make it into the screen. But let's see if we can get a picture of our Gators. They did a great job this week helping our freshmen learn some cheers at Wings. I think it's paying off in the stands. I see people wearing Hawaiian clothes, and they're really ready to rock. All right, let's get ready for the kickoff here, folks. And that's the end of the first quarter, folks. Great start for Arrowhead, 21-0. Second quarter coming up next with Waukesha South having the ball.
early flag on the play. Ball start on the Blackshirts. Third down and six. It is good for a first down for the Warhawks to the Blackshirts 41-yard line. Gain of 18 yards on the play. Carry for the Warhawks. Gain is to the Blackshirts 35-yard line. Gain of 6, second down and 4. Number 13, Tommy Darrell on the
first down, Arrowhead. Here's a little update for you guys. There is 10 minutes and 50 seconds left in the second quarter. It is first and 10 from the 28-yard line, and the score 21-0, Arrowhead. Ooh, pass incomplete up the middle. That one was intended to number 85, Jacob Parsons. Jacob is a junior and a great addition to this team. Now, 10 minutes and 31 seconds to go in this half. Second and 10, Arrowhead with the ball on their own 28-yard line. Third and 15, ball on the 33-yard line. 10 minutes and 13 seconds to go this half. Oh, there's a flag on that one. We have a false start on Arrowhead. That's going to bring it back 5 yards. And we're looking at 3rd and 20 from the 33-yard line now. 9 minutes, 56 seconds left in the second quarter. And the score is 21-0, Arrowhead over Waukesha South. Fourth down and 20 from the 38-yard line, and the punting unit is coming on. Number 4, Ty Bittman back. He's ready to kick this. Oh, nice play. Okay. The ball has been downed on the 9-yard line, I believe. And Waukesha South gets the ball. They're still looking for their first points of the ball game and their first points of the season. Hopefully, Arrowhead's defense is able to continue doing what they've been doing and keeping the Blackshirts off the board. We've got a great halftime show coming up for you guys today. We will have the marching band performing a great show with a few songs that you just might remember from the good old days when rock was good and music was done without any sort of auto-tuning and dubstepping. I'm also looking forward to seeing the Hawkettes and the cheerleaders perform at halftime. They've been working hard all summer to entertain you guys this year, so I hope you tune in. But if you have to go get a break, go to the bathroom, get some snacks, no problem, because this live stream is going to be up for you to watch at any time. You will also have the ability to rewind and watch your favorite plays over and over again, anytime you want. 2nd and 10. Blackshirts ball on the 11, their own 11-yard line. Hopefully the Warhawks can get a good stop here.
Head off to number 47, Joseph Kulak. Check on the play by number 5, Don't Know, route of number 3, Will Bonk. No gain on the play, 3rd down and 10.
Fourth and 10, Waukesha South is about to punt. 8 minutes and 34 seconds to go in this half. Ooh, he barely got that one off, folks. That is going to be a big play for Arrowhead. They're getting the ball back on the 4-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal, and they are going to be in a great position to tack on to this lead before halftime. Right now it is 8 minutes and 24 seconds left in the half. 21-0, Arrowhead up against Waukesha South, and they have just gotten the ball back. Well, they're taking over on the 3rd yard line. And in comes our offense. Timeout, Blackshirts. Great run there. Touchdown, Arrowhead. 27-0. 8 minutes, 20 seconds left to go in the second quarter. On comes the extra point unit.
Kickoff goes into the end zone. Blackshirts will take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
First and 10, Blackshirt ball, 28-0. Arrowhead's got the lead with 8 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the first half. Blackshirts tried to run it up the right side, but they did not get much success. Second and 10 coming up next. 8 minutes and 5 seconds, and the clock is counting down to halftime. Incomplete pass. Third and 10 coming up from the 20-yard line. 7 minutes, 30 seconds to go. The score is 28-0.
Pass attempt is incomplete on the play. Pressure the quarterback number 57 for the Warhawks. On our hand for number 84 from Blackshirts, Ian Gilliter.
Fourth and 10, Waukesha ball. Arrowhead takes over at the 50-yard line. 7 minutes, 15 seconds to go. 28-0 Arrowhead.
Warhawks have a first and 10 at their own 49-yard line. Carry again for the Warhawks. Brought down by number 56, Alexander Bortos. Gain is good for a first down to the 38-yard line, first and 10 for the Warhawks. Gain of 10 on the play, good for another first down to the 28-yard line. Pass attempt is complete to number 34, Braden Arnett. Brought down on play by number 26, Ezekiel Diaz. Gain of 8 on the play, second down and 2 from the 20. On the carry again for the Warhawks. He takes it inside the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Warhawks at the Blackshirts 8-yard line.
Third down and goal from the 20. The score, 28-0. Arrowhead has the lead over Waukesha South. The time, 4 minutes and 39 seconds and counting down until halftime. So far, things have been going great for Arrowhead Warhawks. They have the lead and they are in a good position to add on to it before the half. Beautiful kick, and that one is good. The score has now been increased to 31-0. 3 minutes and 35 seconds left until halftime.
And a reminder, there is a 50-50 raffle being held by the cheer team. Tickets are 2 for $5, 5 for $10, or 15 for $20. You get a chance at 50% of the profits. Ticket table is located at the north entrance of the stadium. The winner will be announced in the second half. And you must be present to win. Kickoff goes into the end zone. Blackshirts will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. George McNello on the carry again for the Blackshirts. Tackle by number 73, Kevin Hughes. And up in the middle, number 47, Joseph Kulap. He is out to the 26-yard line. Third down and 4 for the Blackshirts. Tackle by number 77, John Henry Slayer. Number 2, Jordan McDowell on the carry. Brought down on the play by number 53, Eric Pauley.
If you're just tuning in, the score is 31-0. Arrowhead has the lead over Waukesha South. There is a minute and 50 seconds left until halftime, and the Blackshirts have the ball on the 29-yard line. It is 4th and 1. Oh, and looks like they came up short. Arrowhead gets the ball back with a minute 38 to go in the half. Oh, deep pass for the end zone. Oh, incomplete. Robbie Simden almost came up with the great touchdown, but instead he was ruled out of bounds. I don't think Coach Rauch has a red challenge flag to throw, but if he could, he might want to have another look at that one. I'm not saying the official made a bad call. I'm just trying to point out that there is no challenge flag option here. This is high school football, and the call stands. Hand off to 29, and Nielsen takes it up the middle for a couple yards. You know, I had Josh Nielsen in my English class a few years ago, and let me tell you, he's not just a great running back, he's also a great student, and more importantly, a great person. Minute and 6 seconds left to go in the half. Nice run by the quarterback there. First and 10 from the 12-yard line. 53 seconds left and counting. The Warhawks have a good opportunity to add on to their lead here. They're up 31-0, but they're in great position. Ooh, pass to Nielsen is complete, but he had nowhere to go as he was stopped on the 10-yard line. Second and 8. The clock is at 27 seconds and counting down. Ooh, nice run, but it came up just short. 8 seconds left, and the Warhawks call timeout. There will be 7 seconds to go in the half. Ooh, it will be 3rd and 1 when play resumes from the 3-yard line. You can definitely tell that the community is very excited to have high school football back. The crowd, it looks pretty full. There's a few openings, though, in the bleachers still. I see a few spots still open if anyone wants to come on down. Plenty of room for you, folks. For our incoming freshman class, this is their first ever high school football game as part of the school community. Now, many of them have been coming to games for years as middle schoolers, but now they get to sit in the student section. Very cool. This means they get to participate in the cheers, in the theme, which, as I mentioned earlier, is Hawaiian tonight. And everyone's really excited. They're excited to have football back, and they're even more excited the great start that Arrowhead has started off to. It's 31-0, 7 seconds left in the first half, 3rd and 1 from the 3. Hand off to Nielsen, and he's in! Touchdown, Warhawks! And the lead climbs even higher. This lead is soaring high like a Warhawk. 37-0, and in comes Ty Bittman to try to add on the extra point. Good. 38-0 Arrowhead. Waukesha will be getting the ball back on the kickoff with 4 seconds to go, and then we'll have halftime entertainment. Like I mentioned, folks, do not go anywhere. We have the Hawkettes dancers, we have cheerleaders, and we have the Arrowhead marching Warhawks. There's a lot to see, folks. Do not go anywhere.
Kickoff is returned to the 25-yard line by number 9, Bradley Kuzinski. That ends the first half. Halftime score, Arrowhead Warhawks 38, Waukesha South Blackshirts 0.
This summer, the football players were not the only ones working a sweat here out on the turf this summer. So too was the marching Warhawks. They're out for band camp, working hard, learning the drill. And now, here's your chance for the first time in 2019 to see the marching Warhawks show. Enjoy, everyone.
Tonight, the band performs the 2007 hit, The Pretender, from the Foo Fighters album Echoes, Silence, Patience, and Grace. This song was number 47 on Rolling Stone's list of 100 best songs of 2007, and was a 2008 Grammy Award nominee for Best Rock Song of the Year. Thank you. of Berkwald and Brandy Pallada. The marching Warhawks are under the direction of Jacob Poensic, assistant director Sarah Dinmer, and drumline instructor Jahi Moore.
Job by the Hawkettes tonight. I don't know about you, but that definitely made me lose control. Welcome back, sports fans. The second half is about to begin. If you're just joining us, the score is 38-0. Arrowhead is leading against the Waukesha South Blackshirts. If you took a little snack break, it's time to come back to your screens. Action is about to resume. Waukesha South is getting set to kick off to Arrowhead, and the Warhawks are hoping to increase their lead and keep up the defensive dominance that they've displayed thus far. That kickoff was caught by Tanner Shutt, and it was returned a few yards, and the Warhawks are getting the ball on the 42-yard line. First and 10, and the third quarter is underway. Now it's 2nd and 11 from the 45-yard line, 10 minutes and 34 seconds left to go in the third quarter, and the clock is ticking away. Nice run up the middle by number 11, junior Brady Russ. We're coming up on 3rd and 2 from the 36-yard line. The score, 38-0. Arrowhead leading Waukesha South.
And about a little good for a first down for the Warhawks. Taken by number 11, Brady Russ. Brought down by number 47, Joseph Kula. First and 10 at the 27-yard line. And up at the middle for the Warhawks. Loss of 3 on the play. Second down and 13 from the 30. With 13, Tommy Darrow on the keeper. Tech on the play by number 10, Sebastian Jefferson, and also helping number 43 for the Waukesha, Owen Cruz. Davis in the 53-yard line.
Third and six now from the 23-yard line. 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. Ooh, number 11, Brady Russ, almost broke free there on the sweep to the left.
That looked like a sweep to me, Ryan.
Thanks, Michelle. Now it's fourth and one, and it looks like Arrowhead's going for it. Ooh, good effort there, but the Blackshirts were able to get the stop.
And up to number 47, Joseph Kulab for the Blackshirts.
Oh, wow. A turnover and a touchdown for your Warhawks. Wow, what a play. Unbelievable. 44-0 Arrowhead. All those defensive drills have certainly been paying off. And the kick is good. That was a new kicker in, number 99, Ethan Bodway, to give the Warhawks the lead, 45-0.
Kickoff goes out of bounds. Blackshirts will take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line. Pass is complete to number 10, Sebastian Jefferson. Brought down on the play by number 99 for the Warhawks. Also on the play, number 53, Everett Foley. On the carry for the Blackshirts. Gain of 3 on the play, second down and 7. Pass attempt is incomplete. Intended for number 26, Ezekiel Cruz. Back on the coverage for the Warhawks. Number 24, Sam Pollmacher. Third down and 6 from the 26. Carry for the Blackshirts. Game is down to the 20-yard line. Good for a first down for the Blackshirts. First and 10 at the Warhawks 20.
It is now first and 10 for the Blackshirts from the 20-yard line. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Nice catch there for the Blackshirts. It's going to be first and goal from the 1 yard line. The Blackshirts are looking to get their first points of the game. Ooh, it looks like a stop and a flag on the play, too. It looks like a false start on the Blackshirts. It is now first and goal from the 6 yard line. We are under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. 45-0, Arrowhead has the lead. and the South Blackshirts are looking to get their first points of the game. Ooh, the quarterback tries to keep it himself, and he runs, but he gets stopped. Oh, there come the flags. Flag on the play. Coach Rock wants a little bit of an explanation on what that flag was for. The officials give it to him. And let's see what the result is going to be. After the flag, we have first and goal from the 2-yard line. Blackshirts trying to punch it in for their first points of the game. This is the final play of the third quarter. At this time, I would like to remind everyone that sportsmanship is important at all high school football games. Remember, when you're at the game, you're representing not just yourself, but your school and the community too. So let's keep it classy, folks. All right, and now back to the action. Looks like we're having some clock issues, folks. I know you can't see the clock at home, but we are counting down and trying to get the clock right. This should be the last play of the third quarter. Oh, we got 4 seconds left on the clock, and it looks like we're finally ready to get back to the action. I take that back, folks. We are not ready to get back to the action. There is continued discussion occurring on the field. People are pointing at the clock. Oh, and now it looks like we're back to go. Okay, 40 seconds is back up, and now we're going. All right, number 2 has the ball. He's running. The defense is pursuing. Uh-oh, here we go. Ooh, and Arrowhead gets the stop. It'll be second down and goal coming up next. Great job by the defense, keeping the quarterback out of the end zone. And that's the end of the third quarter, folks. Fourth quarter coming up. And we hope you stay tuned for what should be an exciting end to this game. Great stop there on defense by number 24, Sam Pulvermacher. He was able to bring down the black shirt runner before he could get in the end zone. It is now fourth down and goal. 11 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the game. The clock is counting down. And we have a timeout from the Blackshirts.
Again, the winning number for the 50-50 raffle, 178-233. 178-233. I see our representative walking down to the 50-yard line, holding up the bottle of 50-50. That would be your clue as to who to go to collect your money. 178-233.
From the two, 11 minutes, 22 seconds left to go in the game. Arrowhead is up 45 to nothing. You know they like to keep the shutout intact, so this play is pretty big for the defense. Oh, and he gets it in the end zone. Waukesha South gets their first points of the game. It is now 45 to 6. Great play by the Blackshirts to punch that one in the end zone. Now their kicking unit is on to try to get the extra point. There's the snap and the kick, and it is good. 45 to 7.
That makes the score of the Warhawks 45 and the Blackshirts 7 with 11:18 to go in the fourth quarter.
It is now 3rd and 9 with 9 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the game. 45-7, Arrowhead is leading Waukesha South. Even though there's a big point differential, you can tell that neither team is giving up. This early in the season, the coaches and the players are both trying to learn a lot about their teams, and they've still got a lot to play for. Nice catch to number 85 there. And that's an Arrowhead first down.
That's so by number 12. Jackson Denke. It is good for first down for the Warhawks. At the 45-yard line.
85, that's Jacob Parsons. He's a junior this year. And that was a great play. Now it is 1st and 10 from the 45-yard line. 8 minutes and 35 seconds to go in the game. Gain of about 1 there for the Warhawks. 2nd and 9 coming up. Ooh, never mind. 2nd and 10. Oh, now they gave him the yard on the scoreboard. 2nd and 9. They faked me out twice. Okay. 8 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the game. 45-7 is the score. And Arrowhead is marching down the field. The Warhawks currently have number 12 in at quarterback. That's Jackson Tanky. He is a junior this year. And I can tell you from my experience with him in the classroom that he's a very nice young man and a gifted to what is clearly a very gifted quarterback. Oh, flag on the play. False start there, so we're going to have a 3rd and 14 coming up. 7 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the game, and the clock is ticking down. Tanky gets the ball, and he's, oh, it's a handoff to 82. 82 gets to about the 46-yard line, and here comes the punting unit. 82 was Jake Bloomer on the run there. He is a sophomore. Nice effort there, Mr. Bloomer. Oh, flag on the play before the punt is even kicked. It's going to be on the offense. Offsides there. It's going to bring it back 5 yards. Fourth and 16 from the 39-yard line. The punter is standing at right about the 24-yard line. Blackshirts back to receive. Oh, the punt, the snap is high. He gets it and he gets the punt off though. Very nice recovery. And the ball is downed at the 38-yard line. Blackshirts take over, looking to get a couple more points up on the board before this game ends. 5 minutes and 5 seconds to go. The score is 45-7.
On their own 39-yard line. Thank you.
first and 10 for the Blackshirts from their 39-yard line. Oh, they pass out to the left at number 13, and he gets to about the 48-yard line. Even though this game is not close, you have to give credit to both student sections. We have fans who are not going anywhere. They are staying to support their teams. You gotta love that. They've been anxious for the football season to start, and here it is, and they're gonna enjoy every second that they can. Nice first down there for the Blackshirts as they continue to stroll on down into scoring position. You know, I haven't seen my good friend yet today. I have not seen Wally the Warhawk anywhere yet. Where has Wally been?
I have not seen Wally either.
Hopefully he's okay. Maybe he's, you know, with his flock. Do Warhawks have flocks? I'm not quite sure. Definitely have friends of some kind, though. That'd be a good t-shirt, Wally's Flock. Okay, second and one from the 36. Blackshirts are running the ball right up the middle. And that should be enough for the first down. You know, fun story about how the Waukesha South School became the Blackshirts. They used to be the Cardinals. But unfortunately, there were a lot of other teams in the area who were also the Cardinals. And you know what? At one point, their coach just got so fed up about all the arguing about who really got to be the Cardinals that he said, you know what? We'll be the Blackshirts, because black was one of their colors. It seemed like a unique name at first, but now that I know the story, I gotta say, I'm a big fan. If anyone out there wants to fact check that, please do so. And if I am wrong, please email me and let me know. I think that's the real story, though. I read it somewhere. We only have a minute and 37 seconds left in the game. 45-7, Arrowhead has the lead. Thank you to all our faithful viewers for tuning into our first game of the 2019 season. All right, it's third and eight from the 30, a minute and 6 seconds to go. It's fourth and six, 22 seconds left of the game, and this one is almost over, folks. Ooh, incomplete pass. But I think that's gonna do it as the clock continues to wind down. Our final score here is 45-7. Arrowhead gets the win. Thank you for tuning in, and have a great start to your school year. Look at everyone shake hands, you guys. This is great. These two teams are certainly putting the class in the Classic Eight. And with that great line, we are signing off. Have a great night, everyone.